If you know much about Pokemon Go PvP, then you probably know that hundos, or Pokemon with perfect 15-15-15 IVs, generally aren't optimal for Great League and Ultra League. For example, PVPoke claims that in Great League, Clodsire's optimal build is level 30.5 with IVs of 0 attack, 14 defense, and 13 stamina. The reason that these imperfect builds are better is that these leagues have CP caps, 1500 for Great League and 2500 for Ultra League. The optimal Pokemon for one of these leagues is the one that has the best combination of level and IVs that fits under the CP cap. You might also already know that attack is the first stat to be dropped to stay under the CP cap, and the optimal build often has an attack stat very close to zero. As a result, you might have a general idea that Pokemon with close to 0-15-15 stats are the best for Great and Ultra League. And yet, PVPoke confidently claims a very specific build, the level 30.5 Clodsire with 0-14-13 IVs, is the best. How exactly do they know that? I didn't know the answer until very recently, when I decided to build a tool to convert CP to possible level and IV combinations. I wanted to include Great and Ultra League ranking information, so I had to learn exactly how these rankings worked. I had so many questions. Why is the attack IV generally close to zero? Is CP a bad measure of Pokemon effectiveness? If CP is a bad measure of Pokemon power, then how do we actually calculate the optimal IVs? Are these IVs always optimal? In this video, we'll answer these questions in detail. I'm an indie game developer, and I made a game called Merchants of the Stars, available now on iOS, Android, and desktop. Links down there. It's a traffic control game where you guide cargo ships by tapping and dragging them, helping them reach docks to unload. I'm excited for people to try it, and I'd love to hear what you think. Play it now on the platform of your choice by following the links below or going to taogames.ca/MOTS. To understand how we figure out optimal stats for PvP, we first need to talk about what we're actually trying to optimize. There are two main measures of Pokemon power that are used in different situations. The first is damage per second, or DPS. This measure ignores the defense and health of the Pokemon and focuses only on its ability to deal damage quickly. This is a useful measure for raids, sometimes referred to as PvE, because raids have a timer and allow you to use an unlimited number of Pokemon, reviving them as often as you'd like. This means that you need to do damage as quickly as possible to avoid the timer running out, and reviving a few times isn't a problem. For example, if you can use 30 Pokemon and do 1000 total damage in 3 minutes, this is better than using 10 Pokemon and doing only 900 total damage in 3 minutes, even though far more Pokemon faint. For DPS, Pokemon with relatively high attack and low defense stats, sometimes called glass cannons, shine. Shadow Pokemon, with their attack buff and defense nerf, are also particularly useful for DPS. But for battles against other trainers, called PvP, damage per second isn't the best measure. This is because you're limited to only 3 Pokemon without revives, so Pokemon survivability is an important consideration. In PvP, the best measure is instead total damage output, or TDO. This is the amount of damage that a Pokemon does over its entire lifetime before it faints. For example, if a Pokemon's damage per second is 10, and it lives for 15 seconds, then its total damage output would be 10 times 15, or 150. Optimizing TDO is not the same as optimizing DPS. If a Pokemon has a DPS of 5 and lives for 10 seconds, this gives a TDO of 5 times 10, or 50. This is a higher TDO than a Pokemon that has a higher DPS of 10, but lives for only 4 seconds, a TDO of 10 times 4, or 40. To understand why TDO is the correct measure for PvP, let's look at a simplified example. Let's say that your opponent's team of 3 Pokemon has total health of 1000 HP. If your team has a TDO of more than 1000, then you win. That is, before fainting, your Pokemon can in total do more than 1000 damage. If you have a TDO of less than 1000, then you lose, since you failed to faint all of the opponent's Pokemon before yours fainted. Time isn't a factor in PvP, so DPS by itself is irrelevant. If your TDO is high enough to beat your opponent, then you'll win. Of course, in a real battle, the TDO is not fixed. It'll be higher for favorable matchups, where your Pokemon's attacks are super effective, and lower for unfavorable matchups, where your Pokemon's attacks are not very effective. But it remains the case that for a given matchup, having a higher TDO will always make you more likely to win. So the question becomes, How do we optimize IVs for total damage output? Are the same IVs optimal across all matchups? At first glance, this seems quite hard. Do we need some kind of combat simulation? Fortunately, no. It turns out that because of the way damage is calculated, there is a straightforward way to do it. Here's the damage formula. In this formula, the floor and plus one are both small adjustments that ensure the resulting damage is an integer and non-zero amount. Most of the time, these make a very small difference, so we'll simplify this formula slightly by removing these small adjustments, giving us this simplified damage formula. Now, let's calculate a Pokemon's TDO for a given opponent. Remember, the TDO is the amount of damage that your Pokemon can do before fainting. This can be calculated as its damage per second times how long it lasts. For example, if it does 5 damage per second for 3 seconds before fainting, then its TDO would be 5 times 3, or 15. Its damage per second can be calculated as damage divided by its attack rate. For example, if it does 10 damage per attack and attacks once every 2 seconds, then its damage per second would be 10 divided by 2, or 5. Your Pokemon's time to fainting can be calculated as its total HP divided by the damage per second of its opponent. So if your Pokemon has 10 HP and its opponent is doing 5 damage per second, then it will last for 10 divided by 5, or 2 seconds. Putting this all together, we get this formula for TDO. Now, let's expand the damage terms using the simplified damage formula we were looking at before. This looks a little intimidating, but remember that what we care about is optimizing TDO, and given a specific matchup, we're looking at the effect of your Pokemon's attack, defense, and stamina stats. For attack, we see that TDO is directly proportional to your Pokemon's attack stat. This means that if your attack stat is doubled, then TDO doubles too. This makes sense. If you do twice as much damage and everything else is the same, then you'll do twice as much damage before fainting. Similarly, we see that TDO is directly proportional to your Pokemon's defense stat. This means that if your defense stat is doubled, then TDO doubles too. This also makes sense. If you take half as much damage and everything else is the same, then you'll live for twice as long, and thus do twice as much damage before fainting. We see that TDO is also directly proportional to your Pokemon's stamina stat. This means that if your stamina stat is doubled, then TDO doubles too. If you have twice as much health and everything else is the same, then you'll live for twice as long, and so do twice as much damage before fainting. So it turns out that all of attack, defense, and stamina are equally important to total damage output. Now that we know that all of attack, defense, and stamina are directly proportional to TDO, we can introduce another measure, called stat product, that is also directly proportional to TDO. Stat product is calculated as attack times defense times the floor of stamina. We use the floor of stamina because the game rounds down to calculate HP. For example, Clodsire has base stats of 127 attack, 151 defense, and 277 stamina. If it has IVs of 0, 14, 13, then its stats before level adjustment are 127, 165, 290. If it's level 30.5, then it has a CP multiplier of about 0.735. Then its stat product is 127 times CPM, times 165 times CPM, times the floor of 290 times CPM, which is about 2.4 million. Stat product is proportional to TDO. We see that by replacing the attack, defense, and stamina terms in the TDO formula with stat product. If stat product doubles, then TDO doubles as well. This means that if stat product is maximized, then TDO is maximized. And so, to optimize TDO for a given matchup, we just need to optimize stat product. This gives us a practical method to figure out what IVs maximize TDO. This is a convenient time to explain why the attack stat is generally so low in optimal IVs. For example, with Clodsire having optimal IVs of 0 attack, 14 defense, and 13 stamina. While we see that attack, defense, and stamina are all equally important to TDO, they aren't equally weighed when calculating CP. This is the CP formula. Simplifying slightly by removing the floor, we see that CP is proportional to attack times the square roots of defense and stamina. The square root defense and stamina terms have considerably less effect on the CP than the linear attack term. This difference means that while quadrupling the attack stat will quadruple the CP, quadrupling the defense or stamina stats will only double the CP. This means that while increases in the attack stat are worth the same as defense and stamina to TDO, the measure that's actually important to PvP, they are worth much more to CP. In a CP-capped league, the attack stat should then be avoided, since it costs more in CP than it's worth in TDO. This explains both why low attack stats are preferred and also why CP is a bad measure. It doesn't correlate well with TDO. With that aside, let's get back to calculating optimal stats. We learned that success in PvP relies on TDO, and TDO is proportional to stat product, which is attack times defense times stamina. So, now it's simply a matter of figuring out what level and IV combinations provide the maximum stat product under either 1500 or 2500 CP. The way we do that is to just try all the combinations. To illustrate this, I wrote some code to calculate the stat product of Clodsire with every level and set of IVs. For each combination of level and IVs with a CP under 1500, we check the stat product and select the level and IVs combination that gives us the highest one. The code finds that a level 30.5 Clodsire with 0.14.13 IVs has the optimal stat product under 1500 CP. Wonderfully, this matches PVPoke. So, you should now understand where these IV recommendations come from. But, are there any situations where these might not be the optimal IVs? Definitely, there were a lot of simplifying assumptions made along the way, hand-waving away floors and plus ones. On top of that, we assumed that damage is very consistent, but in reality, a large amount of damage is delivered in very spread out chunks due to charge attacks. In specific matchups, this could make a difference. And for very meta-relevant matchups, it might be worth actually simulating battles with different IVs to understand what happens. Nonetheless, most of the time, optimizing the stat product optimizes performance in PvP. This video has only covered ranking IVs within a particular Pokemon species, but you may also be wondering how sites like PVPoke rank different Pokemon species. Unfortunately, this has no similarly tidy answer. Different sites use different simulation strategies to rank Pokemon, and, for example, PVPoke describes in detail the methodology they use to rank Pokemon. Ultimately though, since Pokemon Go battles are a rock-paper-scissors type game, there is no correct answer to which Pokemon is the best. Be sure to like, subscribe, and check out my game Merchants of the Stars at taogames.ca/MOTS, available now on iOS, Android, and Steam. Bye for now!